In the previous part, we talked about the structure of the dicot stem. Now, in this dicot stem, we also find secondary growth. So, there are two places where secondary growth takes place. We'll be taking these two one by one. The tissue which is formed and which we have drawn here, this is the primary tissue. Primary means the first formed tissue. After some time, the plant is going to increase in girth because the apical meristem is responsible for increase in height. If a plant just is with slender stem and just becomes taller, then that less thickness is not going to support the height of the plant. So the plant has to increase in girth. So secondary growth is responsible for increase in girth. Two places where secondary growth takes place. First is in the vascular region. In the vascular region, all the cells which are present inner to endodermis are also termed as stellae, and that is why the growth which is taking place in this region is known as intrastellar. So in the vascular region, or we will also call it intrastellar, because this region, complete region inside endodermis, is known as stellae. Now what happens here? We will be drawing only the vascular bundles which are present in the ring. So these are all vascular bundles. We know that these vascular bundles are open. That means there is a cambium strip which is present. So we are drawing this cambium strip which is in the vascular bundle. And that's why we have kept this diagram here, so that we'll be able to visualize which cell is undergoing a change. So now these strips of cambium, they are known as fascicular cambium. We'll add one term to this after some time. Now the cells between these smaller cambium strip would also become meristematic. Now, which are those cells which are present between these cambium strips? Between this and this, here is this the medullary rays, that is parenchyma cells. So these parenchyma cells here in this region, they would become meristematic. This process is known as dedifferentiation. So here, the medullary rays or cells of medullary rays undergo dedifferentiation to again become meristematic. This is between these fascicular, so we call it interfascicular cambium. As a result of these two, fascicular and interfascicular, this can also be termed as intrafascicular. So between two intra, there is interfascicular. What exactly we have because of this now? These two together make cambium ring. So there is a ring which is formed. So after some time, what is going to happen? The cells of medullary rays, they have also become meristematic. The process is known as dedifferentiation. We talk about dedifferentiation when we are talking of cell cycle. So we have a cambium ring ready. This cambium ring is going to produce secondary tissue, because it is the tissue which is formed after the complete primary structure is formed. This cambium ring produces secondary xylem on the inner side and secondary phloem on outer side. As the complete ring is active, what is going to happen here? Let me shift or put this same arrangement here. These are the vascular bundles. There's one here. And now we have this complete cambium ring ready. Because I'm going to erase the structures here. The medullary rays, they have also become meristematic. And that's how we have a complete cambium ring. Now this cambium ring produces secondary phloem on the outer side. So here it produces secondary phloem. This is all secondary phloem. Here also this cambium will produce phloem. So the secondary phloem is produced, and because of which the primary phloem is pushed outwards. Same thing continues here. This is secondary phloem. This primary phloem will be pushed outer. So we will get a complete ring of secondary phloem. Primary phloem, wherever it was, it gets pushed out and out. So this is the primary phloem. Whatever is the number of vascular bundles, everywhere we would find that the secondary phloem takes the inner space and the primary one is pushed outer. Secondary xylem is going to be produced on the inner side and complete ring is going to produce secondary xylem. So now here this is the xylem which is being produced. Because of this, the primary xylem will get pushed inwards. The cambium ring produces secondary xylem. Primary gets pushed. This is also secondary xylem. Primary gets pushed inner. Here also the primary comes in. And here also. So what has happened? There are two rings now added. One of secondary phloem and one of secondary xylem. What was the arrangement in the primary tissue? Epidermis, hypodermis, parenchymatous cortex, endodermis, pericycle. Then was the phloem, and this was a part of the primary tissue. So we can call it primary phloem, then cambium, primary xylem and pith. How has it changed now? This part is going to remain the same. After pericycle, so here would be pericycle. After pericycle is going to be primary phloem, then secondary phloem, secondary xylem and primary xylem. And as this growth continues, the complete inner space will be filled with the primary xylem. Primary xylem is mainly made up of dead cells. So slowly and gradually, this living parenchymatous pith will be crushed. So after some time, the central position will be completely occupied by the primary xylem. So this is primary phloem, then secondary phloem, then secondary xylem, and then primary xylem. So there are two rings, complete rings added. So imagine if there is a plant and we add a ring of secondary phloem and a ring of secondary xylem. The girth is going to increase. This is the secondary growth which is taking place in the vascular region. So we said it is vascular region secondary growth, which results in the formation of secondary phloem and secondary xylem in rings. We said that this region, everything inner to endodermis is known as stellae. And that is why it is also known as intrastellar secondary growth, because it is in the stellae region. The second place where secondary growth takes place is in the cortex region. So we can call it the secondary growth in the cortical region, or the other term would be given as, this was stellar region, this is outside the stellar region. So we will call it extrastellar secondary growth. So now in the next part, we will take up the next type of secondary growth. though one is taking place in the inner part and the other is in the outer part, everything is going to add rings of new tissue. So ultimately, both intrastellar and extrastellar would result in girth increase. So next part we'll take up the outer part where the secondary growth takes place.